like to call these materials that I'm interested in wacky oxides. They do unconventional things. You can apply voltages to them and change their structure. You can change their electronic properties. Sometimes you can do both.
These materials are known as multiferroics and allow for electronics to utilize short pulses of electricity rather than the current demands on transistors.
Your computer gets hot as you stream a big movie from Netflix or you're playing your favorite video game, right? There's a current that flows through a transistor, and your transistors always have to have power supplied to them. And that all gets wasted into heat. Why don't we just have them draw less power and give us more functionality out with that less power? The issue is that there's only two known multiferroics that work at room temperature, and they both have serious detriments to their properties. The one key aspect of my research program is to synthesize new ones using something called entropy stabilization, which is a brand new field. We mix a bunch of elements that don't like each other and they don't want to bond, but if you mix enough of them and they form this homogeneous mixture, just the disorder itself can cause it to crystallize. What we're using is a technique called pulse laser deposition. We have a target, and this is basically a crunched powder of species, oxide powders. We direct a nanosecond laser beam onto the target, which causes it essentially to flash boil and atomize everything into an electronic plasma, and you grow your film. What we try to look at is, you know, how do certain symmetries and how do certain chemistries affect what comes out in the material? We can add different elements, we can study distortions, and we're developing techniques to measure these properties as a function of temperature and as a function of deposition. As we go through it and we learn the successes and trials, I'm getting more and more confident that we can stabilize new functional materials with this technique. We're the ones who are setting a pathway and saying, hey, look, well, this is what we've tried and this is what we're doing. This is our successes, this is our failures. And I've always been passionate about multiferroics because I believe that they can be the materials that take the place of silicon and the silicon transistor.